Well, praise the Lord. I am here to give a word. Now, I call Jesus Christ Yeshua. That upsets some people. If you don't want to hear what I have to say because I call him Yeshua HaMashiach, then don't listen. If it offends you, Yeshua said, I'm an offense. So what can I say? Sorry if it offends you, but that's his Hebrew name. He was a Jew, okay? He was a Jew. He wasn't an Englishman or a German or a Russian. He was a Jewish born person. Come to his own. Even at that time, his own did not receive him. But one day, his own will receive him, because it says so in Zechariah. When he comes and they see the nail prints in his hands and his feet and his side. So in Hebrew, his name is Yeshua HaMashiach. When Mary, I can hear it right now. After she cooked supper, she'd go to the door. She didn't say Jesus. She didn't say Jose, because that's what his name is in Spanish. Maybe y'all don't know that. In each language, his name is different comparing to their language, okay? But he said, she would say, Yeshua, supper's ready, come and eat. Because he was a Jew and they spoke Hebrew or Aramaic. So if it offends you, then maybe Yeshua, Jesus Christ, offends you. You need to look in your heart. I'm sorry. But bless you anyway. But tonight, I'm going to talk about the last words of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, here upon this earth. Let's go to Matthew first and see what he said. It's the 28th chapter, beginning with the 18th verse, and it's called the Great Commission. And it says in the English King James Bible, I read from it because there's so many people that won't listen if you do read from anything else. So I stay with it. And Jesus came and spoke unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. All power was given to him. He's telling them, this is some of the last words he said to the apostles and disciples before he ascended back into heaven. What was he saying? Go ye therefore, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. He was saying, he's be with us, even to the end of this earth age. See, the world isn't going to really be destroyed, but this earth age is going to be changed. When the fire begins to come down and cleanse this earth will be renewed, rejuvenated, and become like it was in the beginning when it was first created. Let's go to Mark chapter 16. Verse 15, Yeshua says, go ye into all the world, preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. in my name, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Messiah. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And I'm not talking about snakes. Like, you know, in the Appalachian Mountains, they have religion. Or they go out and get rattlesnakes and things and copperheads and poisonous snakes. And they have them in boxes. And they'll even take them out and hold them and dance with them and praising God and stuff. They think that's what this scripture means. No, it doesn't mean that. It don't mean the physical snake that crawls across the ground. It's talking about the snakes, the demons of Satan, his seed. They shall take up these demons, these seed of the serpent, Satan. And if they drink any deadly thing, so if something comes along and something is poisoned and you don't know it and you drink of it, see, that's why I always pray over everything I drink, over the water I drink, over everything I drink, because our water system is getting so polluted. If we don't, it can harm us. We have microisms and things in waters that can come right into your body and contaminate your body. So you really do need to pray over your water that you drink, over anything that you drink. See, they shall take up as serpents, that's the seed of Satan, demons, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. That's like when I was in Haiti. And the young girl brought a glass of water to me and the gentleman with me because we was wanting something to drink. I drank the whole glass. He only drank about a third or half. And they had to rush him back to the United States because there are parasites in that water. And it caused him to get very sick and have a high fever. And they had to transport him back to the United States because it could have killed him. Didn't even bother me. Why? Because when she gave me the glass of water, I had seen her take it out of a fountain, a pipe out there. And I looked at him. I said, do you think this is the water that she got out there? Because I had pointed it to him. He says, oh no, she knows that we can't drink that water. I said, well, you know, we need to pray over this water. He says, oh no, we don't need to pray over this water. And so I went, well, I am. So I begin to pray and I said, Father, purify this water. Anything that is not good for my body, all the microscopic organs, all the germs, all the diseases in this water, kill it. Make this water pure. Purify it so that I can drink it and it will be good for my body and not harmful. And you know what? That's what happened. God purified that water. I drank it. I was not harmed. He refused to pray over his water. He went back to the United States within 2 days with a high fever, and they thought he was going to die. But by the miracle of medicine and us praying for him, he lived. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. And when I was holding tent revivals and things, I've seen many people healed of cancer, couldn't walk, the blind saw, the deaf heard, the dumb even spoke. I've seen it all happen. And it wasn't by me, it was by Yeshua HaMashiach. When I laid hands on them and I prayed in his name, at that time it was in Jesus Christ. Because I had not come to know the Hebrew name of Yeshua HaMashiach. And I love that name. He is my Messiah. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Now let's go over to Luke. What does it say in Luke? The 24th chapter. Let me see. Let's begin with the 44th verse. And he said unto them, these are the words which I spoke unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled which were written in the laws of Moses, in the prophecies, and in the Psalms concerning me. What is he saying? He says, these are the words which I spoke unto you. In Matthew, at the beginning of Matthew, it says, I did not come to destroy the law, but I come to fulfill. And this is what he's saying. These are the words which I spoke unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which were written in the laws of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms concerning me. The feast, there are seven feasts. All of them are concerning Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. And he has fulfilled every one of them but the last three. That's trumpets, Yom Kippur, and tabernacles. But he is about to fulfill them. Then open he their understanding, that they might understand the scriptures. And he said unto them, this is written, and this is behoving Christ to suffer, to rise from the dead, and the third day. So he's saying, it was written about me, that behold, that I, Yeshua, Jesus Christ, would suffer this death on the cross, and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sin should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning with Jerusalem. You gotta begin with the Jews, Israel, Jerusalem. And ye are witness of these things, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endured with the power from on high. Okay, let's go over in Acts. And then, the first chapter of Acts and the fourth verse, it begins. And being assembled together with them, commanding them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but, and then Yeshua begins to speak, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, ye have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. So, see, he arose and we're getting near to the 50th, about, you know, a few days, just that would be Pentecost. And he's saying, John baptized with water. Mm-hmm. But you people are going to be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days since. Because not too many more days, about 10 days from his ascension was Pentecost. And when they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, what thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? See, they were wanting to know, is this the time you're going to restore the kingdom back to Israel? Because the kingdom was Israel at one time. But it, because of their disobedience, it had been taken away. They had been sent into bondage more times than one. And so they're wanting to know, is this the hour? Is this the day that the kingdom is going to be restored again to Israel? And Yeshua, Jesus, and he said unto them, it is not for you to know the time or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. The Father has put it in his own power. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem. They were always said, begin right here in Jerusalem, and all Judea, and in Samaria, and into the uttermost parts of the earth. And when he had spoke these things, while they beheld him, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of sight. And while they looked steadfast towards heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up unto the heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. And so they returned back to Jerusalem. Jesus's last command was, we are to be a witness for him, beginning in Jerusalem, his people, into Judah, and into Samaria. You know, you start here, you travel over there, you travel down here, and then you just go out to all the world, to everyone, to every creature, to everything. You are to witness my name, me above all things. For I died for your sin and suffered for you. The third day I rose again to give you eternal life. And you are to witness to the whole world what I have done. The price I paid for them. The price I paid for you. This was his last commandments, his last words that he gave. And they are still standing right here, right now, today. Now, people that don't like the Jews or the Jewish nation in Jerusalem, and they are hard against them, you don't understand what you're doing to yourself. Because in the beginning, in Exodus, Leviticus, Deuteronomy, it's been repeated. If you blessed Israel, he will bless you. If you curse Israel, he will curse you. Now, you know, you may not like it, but Israel was then God's chosen nation. Still is God's chosen nation and will always be God's chosen nation. But through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, who was a Jew, part of Israel, gave birth to you, the Gentile nation, so that you too could be grafted in into that natural olive tree that he birthed in Abraham. Abraham was a Hebrew. Go study it in the Bible. He was called out from the land of Babylon. That's what they were over there. Chaldeans, Babylonians. They worshiped a moon goddess. In fact, when our troops went in over there, they found temples to the moon goddess. Abraham's dad, Abraham, his nephew, Lot, because Lot's dad was dead, and their wives all come out of the Babylon nation, the Chaldeans, and headed off towards the promised land. But Abraham's dad stopped on the way, and Abraham was told to go on. And Lot went with him. But there was another brother that Abraham had that stayed behind in Babylon, who had a wife too. He stayed back there in that Chaldean nation, and he was a priest in the temple of the moon goddess, and his wife was a priestess. They had 12 sons also. Go to Genesis and read it. I may put it down below so you can read it if you so desire. So, as God was moving Abraham out, giving him a promise, making a covenant with him, and that he would have a covenant with Isaac, you know, because Isaac was born to Sarah, the free woman, because Ishmael was born of the bond slave, who was an Egyptian. The promise couldn't go to him. The covenant couldn't go to him. It had to go to the free woman's child, which was Isaac, who had Jacob, had two sons, twins, that was born. And Jacob gave birth to 12 sons who would become known of Israel, you know, the Levites, the Benjamites, the Judah, all 12 tribes. While Abraham went out and did God's will, out of his seed through Jacob, which would be renamed Israel, his brother was still back in Babylon, the Chaldean nation, worshiping, being a hierarchy in that religion, had 12 sons. 12 sons that would go against the 12 sons that were of the promise. You know, Satan always tries to duplicate what God is preparing to do. He always tries to get ahead of God. Doesn't do any good, but he does. That's why a lot of the war is going on. There was 12 sons that was born to Abraham's brother and wife, who were the high priest and priestess in this occult religion in Babylon, the Chaldeans. And here comes Jacob along years later, having 12 sons that would be the offsprings that would receive the covenant that God had gave to Abraham, passed on to Isaac, passed on to Jacob, and passed on to the 12 tribes. And then you had Ishmael that would become a nation, and he also had sons that there are still fighting over there with Israel. And then you had, see, Ishmael and Jacob's brother Esau, who had sons, and it was like a multiplication. Everybody was against that covenant that God made with Abraham and passed on to to Isaac. Every one, and there is still a jealousy that God would pick out a certain group of people for whatever reason. I really don't know. All I know that he chose Abraham and Abraham obeyed him and it was proven for righteousness. For some reason, he said, Isaac, you are the chosen one, before he was even born, and named him before he was born. And then Jacob, who was the younger of the twins that was born, he chose him to place on that covenant, that seed on down, because Jacob would have a son amongst the 12 that would be called Judah, and in Judah's loins would be carried down and passed down through time till a little Jewish girl named Mary was born that would carry the body where that the spirit of the Son of God, Jesus Christ, Yeshua, would enter into and become a living human being, predestined to become the sacrificial lamb for all our sins. People don't want to understand this, but it was pre-planned way back there, even in Adam's time, because the seed was planted in Adam and it was passed down through Seth on down till it finally got there, till the Son of God was born, the Messiah, the promised one. And it was prophesied all through the Old Testament. It talked about the promised one that would come, that would be born, the Messiah that would be born. It talked about it and prophesied about it. Isaiah talked about it. Talked about a virgin having a child, a son, Emmanuel. Ezekiel talked about the promised one and even told about him coming back to earth again. All the minor prophets talked about the promised one, the promised one. And who is the promised one? Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. The one that some people don't want to believe in because he happened to be a Jew. You know, when you go against that, you're kicking against the bricks, because he is the rock, the covering. He is the one. He is that foundation that we must build ourselves upon. Because if we build ourselves on anything else, it's like sinking sand. And when the waves begin to beat and the winds begin to blow, our house will fall. But if you build on that rock, that solid rock, that foundation of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, the waves may come up and clash over. The wind may blow mightily. But we are anchored into the rock of salvation through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach. And we will not fall. We will stand no matter what's going on around us. And things are going to get rougher. Things are going to get bad here on earth. Many things. Why? Because of the wickedness of this world. People have become so wicked, so evil, they have lost the concept of who God truly is. They think he's some alien out there, and that we're all little star children of this alien. And they don't even recognize him as the God the only God, they make up a whole bunch of little gods out there. And they don't want to accept Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, because he is the Son of God, the one who paid the blood sacrifice for us. They don't want to accept that. Why? Because they want to go on with their imaginations of their mind, accepting everything that they can see around them. It's okay to be a homosexual. It's okay to go to an abortion clinic and kill your baby. It's okay to deny God. It's okay to deny the Savior, the Messiah. It's okay to push the Passover away and accept an Easter bunny. It's okay to accept all the pagan religions that Rome had and brought into the Catholic Church. And when the other religions begin to come out, they just drug them along with them. They did not go back to the commandments. They did not go back and enter into that covenant that Yeshua had made with the Father for us of soul salvation. The only way. The only way. He says, I am. The only way. I am the door. I am the gate. I am the only way you can get to the Father. You know, if you want to enter my house, you got to come through a door. If you don't come through the door, you're not going to get to see me. That's the way it is up there with God. If you don't come through the door, the Son, the Messiah, you don't get to enter in. You don't get to see him. Any other way that you try to enter in is a thief and a robber. And you don't get to come in. You should have said that very plainly. If you try to enter through the window, wrong way. If you try to crawl in any way else but entering in through the door, through him, because he is the blood, do you understand it always took a blood sacrifice for a forgiveness of sin? And it was his blood sacrifice that he gave for us for our sins to be covered. Now you can accept that or you can reject it. But I'm telling you, Yeshua is coming back to earth soon. And he's not coming as a baby, but he's coming in full glory as King of Kings and Lords of Lords. He is going to rule and reign on this earth. And every knee shall bow before him and confess who he is. Whether you do it now, you will do it then. Believe me. I'd rather do it now. I'd rather repent, and I'd rather bow my knee now 1,000 times over than to have to be forced by his power when he comes down and that power hits you, knocks you down to the ground, and you hit your knees knowing that's the King and you had rejected him. I'm trying to tell you, his name is Yeshua. You can call him Jesus. It's okay. Because in English, it is Jesus. In Spanish, it's Jose. I don't know what it is in German and other languages. I'm sure people could tell you. But I'm telling you, he is the Son of God. And God himself, the Father, set him in authority. All power and all authority is his, given to him by the Father. All authority in heaven, all the angels have to bow to him. And on earth, every human being will have to bow. If you don't do it now, you will. Even the demons in hell will have to bow before him. Satan himself will have to bow before him and acknowledge who he is. He's coming back to earth soon, people. It's time to get your heart right, because a war is about to break out over there in the Middle East, and they're going to go after Israel. And because of the stupidity of our president, and if he doesn't want to back them, we're going to have a crisis in here in the United States that will be unspeakable. If we don't back Israel, judgment will fall upon us. It's time to pray. It's time to get your heart right. Passover is almost here. The first blood red moon is here. And I'm telling you, it is an omen of something about to happen. Mark my word. Bless this video on this Sabbath holy night. Bless the Sabbath day. Let it be an awesome Sabbath day. Reveal many things to many people. Open eyes that's never seen before. Open ears that's never heard before. Take that heart that has been stone and put it into a fleshly heart that it can receive your holy word and become one with you and recognize who you are, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Messiah, the Savior, the Lord. We call you Jesus Christ here in English. Praise be to your name, for it is a name above all names. And we glorify you in your holy, holy name, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. Be blessed on this Sabbath.